Namaste, good morning. Welcome to today's episode. Today we'll talk about a nerve condition or a pain that is faced by few people, but I believe that's something which will be becoming a big problem the way our health conditions are. Okay, so trigeminal neuralgia, TN is what the medical term for it. It's a type of painful nerve pain, especially on the face, where half of the body or half side of your face has unbearable pain, and then you have to take painkillers to subside it. Okay, why I feel this will become a big issue in times to come. See, understand, we are following what the Western medical path had been. So it started with people first became overweight. Okay, then they became obese. Then they had type 2 diabetes, then they had heart disease, then cancer and Alzheimer. Okay, so, and now nerve pain. Okay, this TN condition is the seventh or the eighth thing that we have progressed as a human beings. Similar trend has been followed in our country, where people are following the same trend line from being obese to Alzheimer, dementia right now, and the next is when you start getting this. Why? Because this nerve pain is associated with inflammation. Okay, and we all know that root cause of majority of metabolic disease is inflammation. Okay, the pain here is so intense that it tries to have a pain around your jawline, your teeth, your gum, ear, anywhere on your face you'll have this pain. So what happens is our body is connected through nerves, okay, and there is a central nervous system and a brain. So they're connected through neurotransmitters. Now there is one nerve which is known as trigeminal neuralgia nerve. Now this nerve, when this gets damaged, that's when the pain starts. Okay, now like anything, everything has a protective covering in our body. So like our body is covered with skin, our brain is covered with a membrane, our nervous system is covered, our gut line is covered with a protective gear. Similarly, all our nerves are covered with a sheet which we known as myelin sheet. Now this myelin sheet, when it gets damaged, it can get damaged because of high chronic inflammation, it can get damaged because of age, it can get damaged because of stress led by some high medication that we take. So if it is caused by inflammation, the root cause is inflammation, then the treatment should always be inflammation, not taking painkillers. Okay, now this myelin gets corrosive. So if you have multiple sclerosis as a disease where there is a pain or there is inflammation, this sheet gets inflamed. Okay, now when that gets inflamed, or there is a tumor growth in your body, okay, which is pressing, which presses the nerves, then you'll have this pain. So what causes inflammation? It is systematic reduction in your the protective layer, okay, which is caused by taking too much of omega 6 food versus omega 3. So wild caught fishes are a good source of omega 3, flax seeds is a good source of omega 3. Balancing omega 6, which is through your normal oil and ghee and fat that you take, with omega 3 would be a good idea to reduce. Okay, second is oxidative stress. So any activity that we do, we create free radicals, which when come in contact with oxygen releases there's a toxin in our body which needs to be eliminated. So deep breathing, yoga is one of the key ways to reduce oxidative stress. Third is there is pain that is causing this inflammation, or an injury which is causing this inflammation. So if you treat all these three, you would have a better control over so-called a condition known as TN. So our nerve have got two functions. Okay, one is exhibitory function, one is inhibitory function. Exhibitory function is an activity to go and do things, to run, to be active, to react, to respond. Second is inhibitory, which is to calm down the body, to let you sleep. So if these two nerves do not work, we will not be able to perform either of the activities. Okay, and we all know it is very important for us to be in a sympathetic nervous system as well as a parasympathetic nervous system. So fight and flight is also important, rest and digest is also important. So again, body wants everything to be balanced. Okay, if you just have inhibitory nerves working, that means you will not be active, you will be lethargic, you will just sleep, you can't do any activity. Similarly, if you are exhibitory or more active, you will not be able to relax, you will not be able to repair, you will not be able to detoxify yourself. Okay. Now these two nerves or nerve functions are carried out by two different enzymes. One is glutamate and one is known as GABA. Now glutamate is, which is the exhibitory part, which is action and not do things, versus GABA, which is inhibitory, which is rest and sleep and calming down your behavior. So people who have got high aggressiveness or who got ADD or something, we give them GABA as a supplement to calm down the intense thinking and overdoing things which do not let you sleep, or an activity where process where you can't sleep at the night. So GABA as a supplement is something that helps people. Now, how do you reduce this inflammation? Because if you reduce this inflammation, repair those nerves, you will see a lot of improvement in your pain. So first, to repair, you need to ensure that there is a balance of omega-3 fatty acid versus omega-6 fatty acid. Okay. One is pro-inflammatory, one is anti-inflammatory. So you need to have more anti-inflammatory food like fish oil, flaxseed, walnuts, curcumin, which is found in turmeric, which is a good source of omega-3, or as an anti-inflammatory. So high doses of curcumin, a good quality curcumin will help you. A good source of omega-3, which has got EPA and DHA, somewhere around 1000 to 2000 mg would be of a good help for person. Second way to reduce inflammation is to remove food which is causing inflammation. What food causes? High trans fat. Okay. Second is monosodium glutamate, okay, MSG, or so-called Ajinomoto. Okay. Nowadays, when MSG became as a prohibitory, people have renamed it. So hydrolyzed protein or autolyzed protein, these are few names of certain forms of MSG. So avoid any processed food. Okay, avoid food which has got any form of preservative and sweetener. Okay, aspartame, which is found in dietary beverages, carbonated beverages, or sugar-free beverages. Big source to increase glutamate in our body, which is the exhibitory nerve controller, versus we want it to be GABA. So if you reduce, if you add omega-3, if you add curcumin, if you reduce processed food, if you reduce anything which has got MSG into it, if you reduce anything which has got an artificial sweetener into it, then go for a so-called elimination diet where you understand what are the food which you are sensitive to. For example, dairy is a good source of for people who can get sensitive. So reducing dairy, reducing sugar. Some people have problem with wheat, the gluten part. So going gluten-free for 3 to 6 months is a very good idea to control and manage these nerve pains. What else can we do? We have to look at your hydration level, because the more the hydration is at a cellular level, the better is for the body to reduce inflammation. Regular exercise, okay, minimum 150 minutes in a week, that means 30 minutes 5 days a week is a minimum exercise a person should do. We should have a mix of both cardio as well as strength training. Okay, follow a diet which is low on caffeine. Okay, so coffee, tea, everything, because caffeine increases glutamate, and it rather decreases the impact of GABA. So we want to either reduce glutamate, or we want to eliminate things which suppresses GABA. So looking at reducing caffeine 100%, so no tea, no coffee for you. Green tea on the other hand got less caffeine, but it has got something known as thiamine, which is an extract, which is, or taurine, which is an extract which is given to hypersensitive or hyperactive kids in condition like ADHD or ADD. So green tea is a good inclusion in your diet, but again, with any form of caffeine, take it somewhere around before 4 p.m. or before 2 p.m. in the day. So because the half life, which is 6 hours, so it takes almost 6 to 12 hours for it to subside down in your body. So you want to keep a good gap between your consumption of caffeine and versus your sleep. Focusing on B complex would be a good idea, because nerve, anything to do with nerve pain, numbness, pain, or spasm, there is a chance of B complex being low. So focus on things like vitamin B1, B6, B12 through food, through supplement would be a good idea. Focus on vitamin D3. So B12 and D3 have become a big epidemic right now. So if you all focus on this, it'll be a good prevention for us to prevent ourselves from any such kind of nerve pain, which is basically through heavy metal, which is basically through our inflammation. Last thing that you have to do is focus on reducing heavy metal. So there is a lot of arsenic, lead, copper on the food that we eat, on the cosmetic that we use, on the way we cook our food through non-stick cookware. So looking at a heavy metal detox. A good heavy metal detox is coriander is good, parsley is good, mint is good, blueberries are good. So having green juices or having these food as a part of a diet will help bind toxins and remove them out. Obviously, basis your condition, there would be certain medical intervention that would be needed by a practitioner that you follow. But from a precautionary and from a control perspective, focusing on reducing inflammation through a lifestyle management, through a diet, and through elimination of food that can cause inflammation would help see you getting a lot of relief from trigeminal neuralgia, which is one of a nerve pain condition. Okay. Until next time, stay safe, stay healthy, and we'll catch up soon. Namaste.